Quick warning, some of you may find the images in this next story disturbing. An infant cow slaughterhouse in Grand Isle could soon be back up and running. Bushway Packing was shut down last October for mishandling violations that were allegedly caught on camera and apparently witnessed by a federal inspector. News Channel 5's Mia Moran has tonight's second story.
The undercover video taken by a Humane Society worker at a Grand Isle slaughterhouse set off an outcry from animal rights groups. It even sparked an investigation that is still ongoing into possible animal cruelty charges.
What it showed, I would have expected from what I had seen. You know, nothing was a surprise in the video.
To Dr. Dean Wyatt, a veterinarian with the USDA, the video of employees allegedly kicking and slapping day-old calves wasn't a shock. He inspected the Bushway packing plant daily and shut it down for one day three different times for inhumane violations in the summer of 2009. In one case, he says he witnessed a plant worker do the unthinkable.
There's a down calf at the exit area, and he swore at that calf, and he picked it up, and he just threw it like a football. And it landed on its head and its side halfway down the truck.
Yet the slaughterhouse was allowed to remain open. And Wyatt says he was pulled off the job, sent back to training, after one of the plant's owners complained to his supervisor. A detail he made sure to mention when he testified in Washington in front of a House Agriculture Committee 2 weeks ago.
And so they're weak and they're down and they're injured and they can't get up.
But according to Bushway's attorney, Peter Langrock, Wyatt is mistaken.
He's a self-proclaimed whistleblower. His interest is in his agenda and not in really making things happen properly in the plant.
And he says the U.S. Department of Agriculture's complaint against Bushway has been settled on the condition the slaughterhouse fixed problems with its holding pens and killing practices.
Things that are will help make a better operation.
Repairs that may help, but Wyatt says until the USDA begins enforcing its own rules, slaughterhouses will continue to break them.
It's a real serious problem, and that's one reason I went to Washington, was to really complain about that lack of support that we really need to do our job.
Mia Moran, News Channel 5.